Hello everyone. In this video, I will tell you everything about my gate preparation journey, my motivation, and when did I start it, and how did I prepare for the exam, and finally the tips for the students who are preparing for their own gate exam. Now let's start. So a little background, after 12th class, I gave the JEE exam like everybody else. I did not drop any year for the preparation, nor I did attended any coaching during 11th or 12th classes, but I got a good rank. But the problem was my counseling went horribly wrong. So at that time I did not have any exposure. Because of that, I gave the ordering of colleges wrong in the counseling. I also did not know about the triple IITs at that point. But after all of this, I was getting a good college, good NIT, but the branch was not good. But I want a CSE only. So long story short, I ended up joining JP Noida in Uttar Pradesh. And that too because my cousin has already studied there. So okay, everything was going fine. In my third year, I met my wife. And at that point, we became friends. And I told her this story. And she was shocked. She was like, I mean, how can you do this? I mean, you can easily get good NITs or triple IITs, but yeah, that was gone. So, but from that point, it stuck to her. And she asked me that, why not you give the gate exam? And from there, you can go to top IITs. So at that point, she had the confidence in me that I can get a good rank in gate because of all the story I told her. So that was the initial motivation. But there are some other motivations as well. For example, I will become the alumni of a top IIT, right? And also, if I want to do a PhD in future, it will be easy for me after master's. Even in your college itself, in your master's, you can convert to a PhD. I mean, professors asked me that, do you want to convert to a PhD? So all those things are possible. So because of all that, I started my GATE preparation. So I started the preparation from February 2018. Now, the first thing was that should I opt for a coaching or no coaching? And if I take coaching, that should I take online coaching or the classroom coaching? Now, there is no answer that suits everybody. Now, I will say if your basics are not clear, then you should go for a coaching. And if you do not choose any coaching, you should need a self-motivation throughout your preparation. For me, I choose the coaching because it was for mostly the revision part of it, because the topics, I had the basics clear. I know all the topics, but I want a structured way of learning and a sort of revision. So that is why I took coaching. Now, online coaching versus the classroom coaching. Now, I will tell you the trade-off between the two, and you can decide it for yourself. In online coaching, you can save your commute time, and also it also provides you the flexibility. For example, you can choose to watch videos whenever you want, any times you want, and also you can skip some topics if you already know them. You can also fast forward, you can increase the speed of the video, which helps you. But in the classroom coaching, you get the feeling of the competition among your peers. You can get the real-time feedback on your preparation, and you can also easily clear your doubts with the teachers. In my case, I took the online coachings because you already know my basics were clear. I just need a structured way of learning, and I want to also attend the classes in my college. So because of all those reasons, I took the online coaching. Now my preparation started, but at that point, I was also doing competitive programming. Because I was not completely sure that how will I perform in the gate. So I did not stop doing competitive programming. Because of that, I gave less time to my gate preparation, which that is why it took longer for me to complete the course. I completed the course in December. So it took me 10 months to complete. There are other factors also, because I attended all the classes in my college. I also did 2 months internship in HackerRank Bangalore. So at that point, I was barely preparing. I barely had any time to prepare, right? So in the December, my course was complete. See, the course of GATE is very long. So sometimes you might think that I cannot remember everything I have learned so far. The truth is nobody can. You need to revise the subjects. So when you think you are forgetting the subject, you should revise it. For me, I was revising every subject after 2-3 months. So you can see that. Now the preparation is done. What can you do next? Now, there is one more thing I want to tell. If you are in your first year or second year of college, you have unfair advantage. Now, what is that? See, the GATE syllabus is same as your BTEC curriculum, right? Like there are some courses like CAT and other. The exam material is totally different. But for GATE, the exam material is exactly as your BTEC courses. So what I will say, in your semester, whatever courses you are learning, you should learn them properly. And if your professor is not able to teach properly, it is fine. After the class, I mean, in your own time, you go online, you search the topic and you understand it properly. So that when you actually start your GATE preparation, you have your basics will be already clear and you can easily prepare for it. Okay, so that is how. So the preparation part is done. Now you have, let's say, 1 or 2 months remaining before the exam. At this point, I joined the test series, right? So I took the Made Easy test series. It has been a long time. So now whatever is the famous test series, you should take that. So you should take either 1 or 2 test series based on your speed. Now there are few tips I can give you while solving the test series, right? When you solve the test series, there are some questions you are not able to solve. So after the test is done, when you analyze all the questions, you bookmark the questions which you did wrong or you were not able to solve. Now how that help is, all those bookmarked questions, you go through them before one day of your exam. When you go through them before one day of your exam, all those questions will be very clear in your mind. And if similar question came to your exam, you will be able to solve it correctly. So the point is, you try to minimize your errors. So whatever error you have already made, you just go through it so that you do not make that again. So that is about the test series. Now the second thing is, which most people do not know or do not give importance to, are the online communities for GATE preparation. For example, there is GATE Overflow. There are some, at my time, there were some Facebook groups like GATE CSE GATE preparation, similar groups. So I joined those groups and students used to post questions on those groups and ask fellow members to solve them or give the solution. Now it helps you, first of all, when you see a question, There could be a possibility that you do not know how to solve that question, because the question is from a topic which you have not even covered, because sometimes coachings also miss small topics, but questions can come from that topic also. So from that question, you got to know, okay, this topic also I need to prepare. So you go online and you study that topic. So that is the first benefit. The second benefit is, the questions students are asking, they are tough questions. They are filtered important questions. Now, so what is the advantage? You are getting the good important questions filtered and you are getting an opportunity to solve them. So for example, if you go through a test series or if you go through previous year questions, you will see many questions. You will see some easy questions, difficult questions. But in the online forum, you are getting the difficult questions only. So this way it helps you prepare better for your exam. So for me, I did that, all of these things, and then I gave the exam. And finally, I get the AIR3 in the exam. So this was my journey. I took 1 year to prepare for everything, as I told you, like from February, and exam was on around February only. So yeah, so this was my journey. If you found this helpful, please let me know. If I missed anything, right, ask in the comments. And if you like this video, you can like the video itself, and you can see other videos on my channel. I'm going to prepare a lot of videos on data structure algorithms, GATE, and a lot of different stuff. And I will also keep some motivating videos about the preparation or, right, the career opportunities, all those things I will also do. So for all of those, you can subscribe to my channel and welcome. So I'll see you next time.